Last time on Skyrim, Larry was about to get into a drinking contest with Sam, the gentleman sitting next to him that he is ignoring. Speaking of ignoring, I apologize for not playing this game. I really wanted to get through Deus Ex so that I could move on to new things. And get back to Larry, which, I'm not going to lie, I really do miss this game.
What do you need?
Speaking of which, let's do this drinking contest.
Maybe you just aren't up to the challenge.
You don't stand a chance.
We'll see about that. This is a special brew. Very strong stuff. Let's get started.
Let's do it.
I'll start round one. Down the hatch.
Larry, maybe you should stand up.
Yes?
Your turn.
All right, let's do it.
One down, my friend, one down. All right, and another one for me.
If you need a good rumor or two, I think I can oblige.
And how about you?
Yeah. Larry's not a quitter.
So says you. I think I've hit my limit on these things. Tell you what, one more and you win the contest.
This is no problem.
Wow, you've really done it. The staff is yours.
Thanks, man. That's great.
You know, you're a fun person to drink with. I know this great little place where the wine flows like water. We should head there.
We should.
Hey, you don't look so good.
You are a fantastic guy.
Wake up. That's right. It's time to wake up, you drunken blasphemer.
My head.
Yes, your head hurts and you don't remember where you are. I'm guessing you also don't remember coming in here and blathering incoherently about marriage or a goat. Which means you don't remember losing your temper and throwing trash all over the temple.
Well, as long as he wasn't trying to marry the goat, Cena is a good-looking girl, so, I mean, really, maybe he was trying to sacrifice the goat for Cena. I don't know. I'm hoping that's where it went. I'm hoping it wasn't the other way. And no, you're not going to persuade anyone with a hangover, so let's go with the payment option.
Well, we can always use contributions. You were ranting when you got here, but most of it was slurred. You did say something about Rorikstead. Maybe you should take a look there.
Yes, agreed.
I'm sorry, the Temple of Dibella is closed. You can receive your blessing if you wish, but the other sisters are in seclusion.
Calm down, Larry. Calm down. Let's just talk to her. Oh my goodness. Larry seems to have stumbled into the ultimate temple. Okay. Why is the temple closed?
The sisters are communing with Dibella. They can't be disturbed. You'll have to come back another time. Is there something I can do for you?
Who is Dibella?
A heathen. Lovely. Oh, don't put on that angry look. I'm just teasing you. Dibella is the divine of beauty. She is a patron deity to artists and bards and those who seek life's simple pleasures. The temple offers her blessings to pilgrims. An instruction in enjoying all life has to offer.
Oh, Larry. Yeah, whatever. Still looking for love in all the wrong places.
Well, you are lovely to look at.
What?
And there's so many things I could teach you, but I'm afraid the temple isn't taking in new students.
Aww. Well, it's too bad, Larry.
Dibella's blessing to you.
She's gonna be staring at Larry's buttocks as he walks out the door. But that's fine. Because he was doing the same to her. Let's get a blessing. What the hell did that do? No. Speechcraft. Well, that's great. Let's get out of here, Larry. You drunken idiot. Let's avoid the guards, just in case you did something really bad while you were wasted. What's this? No, that's enough shrines, Larry. You don't need to go wreck another one.
Outsiders.
Wow, aren't you a dickhead jackass?
Blood and silver, friend. Blood and silver.
You want to roll? Is that what you think?
Bloody enough for you, outsider.
Excuse me? More blood is always better. you're talking to the Nerevar here, you Yvongar.
Markarth, is it bloody enough for you?
Are you threatening me?
If I was threatening you, believe me, you'd know it. You outsiders never learn. If the Forsworn don't get you, the guards will throw you in Sidna Mine to work your fingers off. Think that's water in the river? Blood and silver are what flows through Markarth, friend.
What do you mean, blood and silver? I'm looking for work. Oh, Larry. Oh, Lord. Okay, what do you mean, blood and silver?
It's right there in the name of the most powerful family in Markarth, the Silverbloods. They have a whole mine filled with prisoners that dig up silver ore, get smelted by workers they pay, and they own half the city.
It's terrible.
I work for them. The inn is named after them. When the guards make an arrest, they check with them first. No, I live in a nice house in Solitude, where the air isn't filled with smoke from the silver smelters, and golden-haired girls shine my shield. Been here ever since I left the Bard's College. Turns out a few muscles earn more gold than a damn loot. The Silverbloods pay me, let me crack a few skulls, and keep the guards off my back. That's all I need.
That sounds like something Larry would like to dig his fingers into. Larry's not a big fan of oppression.
Bit of jewelry for your journey home? Oh, this pendant would look lovely on my sister.
Oh my god.
I die for my people.
Forsworn are here in the city.
Everyone, stay back. The Markarth City Guard have this all under control. There are no Forsworn here.
The fuck just happened here?
We'll handle things from here. Move along.
Holy shit, a murder just took place in front of Larry.
Move along.
Gods. A woman attacked right on the streets. Are you alright? Did you see what happened?
Yeah, he stabbed her in the back. No, he didn't.
A Forsworn? Strange. Well, I hope the Eight give you more peace in the future for what it's worth. Oh, I think you dropped this. Some kind of note. Looks important.
Want a cut of venison or mutton? Of course you do.
Do you know any... Well, clearly he just slipped us a note, so let's not...
What a waste.
Redguard, do you know anything about the attack?
No. I was just getting some fresh air. Had one too many pints of mead at the Silverblood Inn.
Me too. Okay.
All right, then.
We'll handle things from here. Move along.
Let's search Margaret. Can we take this without going to jail? Apparently we can. Well, let's take that then. And that. We did kill him after all. Okay, so next time on Skyrim, Larry investigates this very odd murder. Stay tuned.